Hey everyone, welcome to another video. Today we're going to be playing Superancient Deepsea King Coelacanth. This is a deck I'm going to call Fish Explosion. I know other people call it different names. I think Fish Turbo is one I've heard. It's all about Superancient Deepsea King Coelacanth. So that's what we're going to be playing today. I'm going to go through pretty much every combo that I know of in this deck. If you like the channel, please consider subscribing. You'll get notified when I make new videos. And I do plan on showing off this deck in a combo video tomorrow. We'll be going on ladder and seeing how this deck does. So be sure to tune in and check that out. All right. So let's go through the cards in the deck. So we got the core card of the deck, Superancient Deepsea King Coelacanth. What he does is if you get him on the field, and that's the goal of this deck, you want to get him on the field, you discard a card, and then you special summon as many level 4 or lower fish type monsters as possible from your deck, but they cannot declare an attack and their effects are negated. Now, that's really good, because basically if we can get this on the field, we can just make pretty much any play from our extra deck we want. We'll have so many monsters on the field, we can do anything. We can do link plays, we can do XZs, we can do synchros. All we have to do is get this on the field. So, how do you get this guy on the field? Well, Konami gave us Lifeless Leaffish. And Lifeless Leaffish is, it's just amazing for Superancient Deepsea King Coelacanth. If you can summon this card, it will send the Superancient Deepsea King Coelacanth directly to your graveyard. And then, if you can get a rank 4 XZ, you can make Dugarrus. And Dugarrus will let you skip your next main phase, that doesn't matter, to special summon a monster from your graveyard. So you can just summon Superancient Deepsea King Coelacanth and go from there. Now, that's great. How else can we do this combo? Backup Lifeless Leaffish. We have Beautiful Princess at 3. You do want to run 3 of these, because if you can normal summon this, it will banish itself to special summon a fish from the deck, so you can special summon Lifeless Leaffish. So really, we're running 6 Lifeless Leaffish in this deck, not 3. And you could even argue that you're running 7, because 1 for 1 will let you special summon Beautiful Princess from your deck, which can get you Lifeless Leaffish. So that's 1, 2, that's 7. You got 7 Lifeless Leaffish, you got a ton of special summoning. That's the combo starters. So another way you can get the Superancient Deepsea King Coelacanth on the field is you can use Ice Barrier. So sometimes, even though you got 7 copies of him, sometimes you're not going to draw the Lifeless Leaffish or a way to get Lifeless Leaffish. So if you can make a rank 4 on the field, you can use the Foolish Burial Good and you can send the Ice Barrier to the graveyard, and then you can use Ice Barrier's effect to get Superancient Deepsea King Coelacanth into your graveyard. So I'll show that off too. So that's why these are in the deck as well. Perry Ria's Map, that's another way to get Beautiful Princess. So you can use this effect to search for a Beautiful. So I guess I was saying 7. We really got 8 ways to get Lifeless Leaffish on the field, because this will get you, it's a little convoluted now. This will get you this, and this will get you this, and that'll get you this in the graveyard. So this deck, it's kind of fun to play, but it's very much a solitaire deck. You're going to be comboing for multiple minutes going on. Your opponents are going to be conceding. They're going to be like, I'm not going to wait for you to finish. So that's, hey, it is what it is, but it is pretty fun. So hopefully I can get some good games out of it. So I think what I'll do is I'll show some of the combos. You'll see what cards are used. And then I'll give you an idea of you know, how to change the deck, because really the core of the deck is Lifeless Leaffish and Superancient Deepsea King Coelacanth, and everything else is just, you know, you choose the way you want to play this deck. You can make pretty much anything you want. So let's get to the combos I have found, and then let's see if we can do some gameplay. All right, let's get going. All right, so here's what you need to do the core combo of the deck. Now, all these cards, especially the rank 4 fish or the level 4 fish, are optional, but the Leaffish, you want 3. You're going to want ways to get Beautiful Princess. So this is my recommendation for the main deck to do the combo. You could fill the rest of the deck in with whatever you like and still be able to do this combo. Now for the extra deck, these are the cards you're going to need. Some of these, now I will say these are the ones you need to do this combo. Some of these are optional. You don't need to run Baron de Fleur if you don't have him. You could run something different. And also, you don't need to run Hulk Fibrax, forgot to take that out. And you don't need to run Area of the Water Charmer. You could use any level 2 generic Link monster. Any Link monster that just needs two monsters as a material and it doesn't care about the type or the effect or whatever. So this is the one I chose, but you could use something else if you wanted. All right, let's go on to the combo. Okay, so here's an example of a textbook combo we have. So we got Beautiful Princess and we got Silent Angler. This is perfect. Doesn't matter that Super Ancient Deepsea King is here. We don't need to use Foolish Burial Goods. If you want to bait your opponent, it's great, I find, if you have Foolish in hand, to start by activating Foolish. If your opponent has Ash, they don't know what you're playing because Foolish is like such a generic card. You could be sending anything to your graveyard. So you can send your Ice Barrier to the graveyard here, and if this gets Ashed, then you're feeling great because you still got your combo. So let's just send Ice Barrier to the graveyard here. Ice Barrier is super useful. We can use it to tutor a Kaiju, or we can use it to tutor a Super Ancient Deepsea King Coelacanth. So let's get Summon in here. Let's summon our Beautiful. This could have been a Lifeless Leaffish as well. And we get the Lifeless Leaffish. This is like core to the combo, this card. And this is gonna Foolish Burial, basically, a Super Ancient Deepsea King to your graveyard. So now you special summon your Silent Angler, or however else you had a way to make a link, rank 4 Xyz. And then you make Dugarrus. And Dugarrus is going to special summon, once we got him on field here. Dugarrus is going to detach 2. And he's going to special summon your Super Ancient Deepsea King back from the graveyard to the field. So from here, you can do pretty much whatever you want. You could, because he's gonna vomit all your fish onto the field here. So let's detach, and let's look at what we can do. All we can choose 4. We got 4 zones here. We can choose 4 fish to put on the field. So what are the best fish to get? So here's my advice. You're gonna want a way to make a level 7 synchro. So of all of these fish, you'll want at least one way to make a level 7 synchro. So that's gonna take up 2 fish probably. So the best way to do it is with Oystermeister and with Swamp Eel. You could also do it with Reptolphin and a generic level 4, any level 4, but the best way to do it is with the Swamp Eel and the Oystermeister. All right, so we're gonna use those 2 cards. And then what else can we get? Well, we could get a lot of stuff, but let's just get 2 level 4s. We could do some level 4 XD plays. All right, so summon them all in defense mode. All right, so what do we do next? Well, let's focus on thinking about comboing more, because you can always combo more with this deck. So what we want to do is we want to get our Super Ancient Deepsea King into the graveyard. Once he's in the graveyard, we can summon him a second time. So how do we get him in the graveyard? Well, the easiest way is with a generic level 2. It'll get Dugarrus off the field, and it'll get the Deepsea King in the graveyard. I got Aria the Water Charmer, because often this deck gets locked into waters, so we're going to use that. We'll get rid of Deepsea King, get him in the graveyard again, get rid of Dugarrus. Alright, now we got him in the graveyard, let's get that fish back on the field. So let's Synchro Summon with White Aura Monoceros. That was why it was important to be able to make a level 7 Synchro. So we'll summon the Monoceros here. And the Oystermeister's effect is going to activate. The Monoceros effect is going to activate. Let's special summon the Super Ancient Deepsea King back to the field. We can do it all again. Get him on field here. And Oystermeister token is going to activate. So keep in mind, this is important to note, you want your Oystermeister token to be in one of these link zones, because we want to get rid of him. We need him to be here, because if he's off to the side, you might not have space to link play. So let's do our link play here. Yeah, this is why. So we want to use Oyster Token to make Appaloosa. And if this Oyster Token is not pointing to one of these link arrows, we're not going to have space to summon Link Karibo, because he needs to be in a zone that's one of these arrows points to. So I always summon the Oyster Token pointing to one of the Link arrows, just so that you're always sure that it works. So, all right, let's get the Link Karibo here. That's for later. And we can do plays with these cards too, so let's do some plays. Let's make a toad so we get more negates on field. Now keep in mind this combo is very vulnerable to Nibiru. You get Nibiru super easily, and there's not much we can do to stop it. Let's send the leaffish to the graveyard. Get our toad here. Alright, now we can... Well, let's do this first here. Cancel. Alright, now we can summon Appaloosa. And that was the reason we put Oyster Token here, was so we could link Karibo. And we can use Link Karibo to make Appaloosa. Link, you can't use tokens to make Appaloosa. So that's why we did that. So we're going to use this. We're going to use this. We're going to treat it as two materials. No, we just want space on the field. So get rid of Bahamut Shark. Get rid of the Monoceros. Now we got four monster negates with Appaloosa. We got four negate Appaloosa. And now we can, this is key here. We have a lifeless leaffish in the graveyard, so we can activate its effect in the graveyard. We can send water monsters back into the deck. Let's send the Swamp Eel. Let's send the Oystermeister. Key to have the like special one-ofs, you want them back in the deck. Send those back in the deck. And a draw card. So now we can activate our Deepsea King a second time. We can do even more plays, so let's get activating here. I'm gonna discard the Call by the Grave because we got lots of monster negates with Appaloosa, and Call by the Grave only negates monsters. And we can summon more stuff. So what do we want to summon now? Well, we got a level 7, so if we get a level 3 tuner, we can make Baron de Fleur, so that's great. Then we'll have two zones left, so what else do we want to make? Well, we can make a rank 4 XE, or we can make Borreload if we get a tuner, a level 4 tuner here, and a generic level 4, we can make Borreload. So let's do that. And get Special Summoning. Get our Borreload. Get two more negates here. Borreload gonna activate. We'll get the Water Charmer. And then we'll Special Summon Baron de Fleur. Alright, so there you go. Let's look at how many negates we got here. We'll activate this fish. This is just gonna boost the Baron. He's good enough, but now he's got 4,000 attack. Why not? Alright, so let's look at what we got here. We got one Omni Negate, 1, 2, 3, 4 monster negates, another Omni Negate, and another Omni Negate. This is the strongest board we can have. We also have Ash in our hand. You often will end up with an Ash or maybe an Imperm or a Call by the Grave in hand that you can use as well. So we're looking pretty solid here. Now keep in mind, this is with your opponent playing Gem Knights, so they don't have any disruption on you. If you get disrupted, your plays are going to be a lot more difficult. But if you're living in Magical Christmas Land, this is like the turn one dream combo. This is your end board. And your opponents will usually concede if you get this far, or maybe they'll concede when you special summon the Deepsea King the second time. But that's the deck. That's the core combo. Let's take a look at other combos you can do with the deck. But keep in mind, this is the one that you'll want to do the most often if you can. Alright, so sometimes you can make Dugarrez and you won't be able to get Super Ancient Deepsea King into the graveyard without using Ice Barrier. So you're going to be locked into waters for the rest of the combo. So these are the cards you can use if you're locked into waters, but you can still do a lot of plays and you can still make a board that's pretty solid with a lot of negates. So I'm going to show that off in the next combo. So here's the cards you need in the extra deck. Here are the water monsters I have in the extra deck that you'll still be able to make even if you're locked into waters. All right, let's go to the combo. All right, so here's an example of, oh no, I have a level 4, but I don't have a leaffish. What do I do? So let's look at what we can do here. We got a Foolish Burial Goods. Now we can activate Foolish Burial Goods. The ordering of this is important. And we can send Ice Barrier to our graveyard. Alright, now ice bears in our graveyard. You gotta be patient here. Let's normal summon our white stingray, special summon our silent angler, and then we can rank Fork Z into Dugras. You gotta do this first. If you activate the ice barrier first, you won't be able to combo. Make the Dugras in defense mode. Alright, now we want to activate the ice barrier. Ice barrier gonna activate. It's gonna send a level 5 or higher water to our graveyard. We're gonna send Superancient Deepsea King. And then Ice Barrier is gonna ask you, add the designated card to your hand. Now take a look at your graveyard. If you ended up with another fish or something else in the graveyard, not the Deepsea King, then you can say yes. If Deepsea King's the only card in here, you say no. You leave him in the graveyard. Now Dugras is gonna activate. Skip our next main phase. Special summon the Deepsea King. All right, so one key thing now, we're locked into waters. We cannot summon anything except for waters. So keep that in mind. So we're gonna activate, we're gonna discard. Now we do have to discard one of these cards. They're both good. Probably doesn't matter here too much. We're gonna have lots of monster negates, so let's get rid of the Imperm. All right, so what are we gonna wanna summon here? We're keep in mind, we're locked in the waters. So we can use this to make a level 8 synchro. We can make as many rank 4 Xyz as we want. And we want a way to make the Monoceros. Because if we can get this boy in the graveyard, we can special summon him again with the Monoceros. So let's get a level 3 tuner, a level 4. This is going to be our way to make Monoceros. And then let's get whatever else we want. So we could just get two level 4s if we want to do a level 4 Xyz. Or we could get Fishborg to do a... let's get Fishborg and a Leaffish. Leaffish we'll want to have in our graveyard, so let's get a Leaffish for that reason. And his effect's negated, so that doesn't matter. Alright, now we need to get Superancient Deepsea King back in the graveyard. So let's get him off the field here. We got our Dragite. Now we can activate Fishborg in the graveyard. We can special summon him back to the field. Now we got so many options here. Now we can't, Hulk of Fibrax can special summon a tuner from the deck, but he can only summon level 3 or lower tuners, so he actually won't be able to summon the tuners that we want right now, but is an option. We can make the Water Charmer. We can make the Monoceros. Let's do that. Like, that's the thing about this deck, and this is why opponents are going to concede when you play it, is you're going to be playing for so long comboing that your opponent's going to fall asleep. Alright, let's activate. Special summon the Deepsea King again. We're locked in the waters, but we're doing this combo anyway. We got him a second time, and because we were smart, we got the Leaffish in the graveyard. We can send monsters back into the deck. So we can send this tuner back. Draw a card here. Now we can special summon the Hulk of Fibrax, or if we want to just clear up space, this is why I have Water Charmer in the deck. So we're locked into waters here. We wouldn't be able to make any other link to with Dugras. This is the only way to get him off the field is with Water Charmer, because Water Charmer is the only water link monster that has the ability to use a generic monster as a target. So that's why we're using Water Charmer here. So it requires one water monster and any other monster. So let's get Dugras off the field. And I guess let's use the Fishborg. Most of our future plays are going to be X rank 4 XC plays. All right, now the only thing left we can do is because we have basically so much, we don't have enough stuff on the field. We can discard the Butuniful And we can get, let's just get a level 4 here. Let's just make another negate. Gonna make Toad. So we did all that while locked into waters. So this isn't the only end board you could have made. You can see there are other lines we could have taken at any point if we wanted to go more into the rank 4 Xyz. But we're ending with a 35,000 attack Monoceros. We got a spell negate, we got an Omni negate, and we just got our whole field full of monsters. So, you know, we're looking pretty solid here for being locked into waters. And we can do it all again next turn. All right, that was that combo. Let's try out some more. All right, so sometimes our deck locks ourselves into waters. Now, this is done intentionally because you want extra ways to get Super Ancient Deepsea King Coelacanth into the graveyard. So I'll show off that combo in a bit. But in order to execute that combo, these are the cards you're going to want. So we're kind of assuming we don't have leaffish on board. So I'm showing leaffish in here because you want to run him. But we're going to show this combo that works without leaffish to tutor the Super Ancient Deepsea King to the graveyard. All right, so you do definitely need a Buzzsaw Shark for this to work. Buzzsaw Shark's pretty key. It's just a way to get a level 4 on the field. And so we're going to be locked into waters. And Buzzsaw Shark's going to lock us into Xyz too. So this is us getting locked into waters and Xyz. Here's the extra deck. Now some of these we won't be able to make because we're locked into Xyz, but we're locked into waters as well. So we can still make Toad, Bahamut Shark, number 37. Dugress we'll make before we get locked into waters. And Stealth Kraken. Alright. Let's go on to the combo. Alright, so sometimes you'll get hands that are a little bit clunky seeming, but you can still use them to combo. And I'll show you how. So say here we have a Lifeless Leaffish, or we have a Beautiful Princess as our normal summon. What are we going to do here? Well, Beautiful Princess, we can normal summon her. Let's get summon in here. And we can get our one of copy here of Buzzsaw Shark. We get Buzzsaw Shark. Buzzsaw Shark can target himself and make a level 4 or rank 4 Xyz. So we can make Dugress here. So we got our Dugress on field. Unfortunately, Buzzsaw Shark locks us into Xyz. Now I say unfortunately, but it's really not that bad. So what we're going to do here is we're going to activate Foolish Burial Goods, since we have that as our kind of extender play here. And we're going to send our Ice Barrier to the graveyard. Alright, now we can activate Ice Barrier here. And Ice Barrier is going to send our Super Ancient Deepsea King to the graveyard. So now we're locked into Xyz, and we're locked into water. So this is going to ask, do you want to add the card to hand? Let's take a look at our graveyard. We want this in the graveyard, so we're going to say no here. Now we can activate Dugress. Special summon our Super Ancient Deepsea King to the field. And now we can activate his effect. Let's discard Ice Barrier because we can activate it again for free basically. And now we can special summon here. Now keep in mind, because we used Buzzsaw Shark, we can only special summon XZ monsters. So no double summoning, no double summoning line. All right. Now let's special summon here a bunch of level fours. Level four. All right. Now we can make Bahamut Shark. Get activated. Get a Toad. And special summon. And we could either make number 37 or we can make a Stealth Kraken. Stealth Kraken's probably better. All right, so there you go. That's what you do if you get locked into X, Z's, and waters. So we got an Omni Negate here. We got a monster pop. And we got a bunch of beefy monsters on the field to stop us from getting KO'd. And we got whatever we had in hand. We got an Ash Blossom as well, but maybe you have some other form of negate. So that's our kind of like worst possible line that we could do. If we get locked into waters and Xyz, we still got interaction, we still got plays. So that's pretty solid. We also got an Ice Bear in the graveyard here, just through the scenario that I happen to have in hand. Ice Bear, if it's in the graveyard, because we're locked into waters, we'll be locked into waters on our next turn too. You can use Ice Barrier on your opponent's turn, and you can get a second search. So in our deck, we have a Kaiju, so let's just pass the opponent's turn here. So our opponent's going to do stuff here. They're going to draw some cards. Whatever, they're playing Gem Knights. All right, they're going to activate Fusion Sage. We don't care about that. Well, we'll Ash. We could Ash it. So let's Ash it here. Just showing that we got some interaction still. And then let's activate the Ice Barrier. So with Ice Bear in the graveyard, because this is what I was trying to show you. If you have another Ice Bear in the graveyard, we're already locked into water, so there's no punishment here. We can send a Kaiju to the graveyard. And we can add a card to hand. We can add any water monster to hand. So we could add Buzzsaw and XD again next turn. Or we could add Gamisiel to hand and Kaiju his monster if he's able to make some monster that's unbreakable. We could have a Kaiju to hand. So now on our opponent's turn, we could Kaiju them. Or on our turn again, we could Kaiju. So his opponent's gonna Fusion Summon. Let's stop that. Get negating. All right. So you've seen, I'm not gonna torment this Gem Knight player anymore. Let's see if we can do one more combo. All right. If you're playing a deck with tuners and non-tuners, then you're gonna be able to do this combo. All you need to do to include it is include a copy of Jet Synchron and a copy of Mecha Phantom Beast O-Line into your deck. If you have these cards in your main deck and you can get a tuner on the field and any other monster, you'll be able to do this play. I'll show you the combo in a minute. For the extra deck, these are the cards you'll need to have. Herald of the Arclight, Boreload Savage Dragon, Hulk of Fibrax, and Mecha Phantom Beast Auroradon. All right, let's get to the combo. All right, now we have the ultimate combo here. We have a Tenshi Spirit, we got a Deepsea Angler, we got a Beautiful Princess. So we could make the Lifeless Leaffish, we could get our Superancient Deepsea King in the graveyard, we could do all that. But let's show off a hand or some card, a play that you can make if you don't have that. Maybe you only have a tuner and a special summon. Maybe you aren't able to make a rank 4 XE. So let's show that off. So let's activate our Tenshi Spirit. And let's summon a tuner here to the field. We're normal summon our tuner. Just pretend we don't have these cards in hand. Maybe our hand's just a bunch of hand traps or something like that. So what can we do here? Now, this is why we got this combo in the deck. This is the Hulk of Fibrax combo. So we're able to make Hulk of Fibrax. We're able to combo. Let's show that off. We'll special summon here. Hulk of Fibrax. Hulk gonna activate. We're gonna get Jet Synchron. And we're going to special summon Mecha Phantom Beast, Auroradon. Auroradon effect going to activate. Special summon a bunch of tokens. And now we can activate our Mecha Phantom Beast effect. Special summon a Mecha Phantom Beast from the deck. Alright. And now, we can make Boreload. Boreload effect can activate. O-line effect can activate. We're going to attach the Auroradon here. Make our token. And now we can activate Jet Synchron in the graveyard by discarding a card. So if we're pretending these could be anything. Discard a card here. Special summon the Jet Synchron. And now we can make Herald. So we got two Omni Negates plus whatever else we had in hand. This is our kind of fail-safe combo. We got the ability to make an Omni-Negate, another Omni-Negate, and any card sent from the hand or main deck to the graveyard is banished. So if our opponent tries to Foolish Burial or discard cards, they're going to get banished right away. They're not going to be able to fill their graveyard up and activate effects. So this is kind of our fail-safe combo. In case, you know, maybe we draw Ash and one Water Monster, we still have a play we can make to make a solid board. Alright, so those are all the combos I'm going to show today. I know there are millions of combos you can do with this deck, summoning, you know, four fish of any type from your deck to the field is going to give you a lot of lines. So if you know some other cards maybe I should include, or maybe some other combos you think I should show off, let me know in the comments. Otherwise, have a great day.